are the user of our software and many doesn't have also. So just have a look on the softwares what we have. So this is our option strategy software. So here some scanners we have given, some inbuilt option strategy scanners, and here you can able to form any scan, any option strategy of your own, and also it has the option intraday, positional, arbitrage facilities here. You have an option scanner also here, which strike will be best suitable for trading. So you can form calendar spreads here. So all these things are in the desktop edition. And mobile edition, these scanners are not there. This particular scanners are not there. However, you have some advanced features there. So like any kind of option strategy you can form there, option intraday you can do, positional you can do. So this is also mobile edition also available. Then this is the software most of you are using, one standard deviation, intraday, positional trade using the one standard deviation. So this software has the option monthly, option weekly, option scanner, stock scanner, commodity feature, and you can able to trade in the equity, stocks, and index future, currency future also. So this software has these features. And this is the WT GAMS software where we can, we have the time analysis when the trend reversal will happen. And recently we have added trend reversal scanner. So whichever the stocks are having trend reversal date falling tomorrow, you can able to scan it today. So today you can able to scan which of the stocks are having a trend reversal date tomorrow. So on 8th of August, so today we are in the 7th. So 8th of August, which of the stocks are having the trend reversal date? So that you can able to scan, and you can also get that price range. What, at what price if they change, if they close today, then you will get a confirmation that yes, they are in the trend reversal band. So that also I am going to explain today. So this is about our GAN software. And we have all-in-one integrated tool. This was having, earlier you have seen that one standard deviation. So various other principle like GAN angle and volatility, what is Elliott, Camrilla, Fibonacci, volatility principle, Fibonacci parallel projection principle, all things are being programmed in this tool along with the pair trade. And it also has the same features like your option monthly, option weekly, option scanner, stock scanner, and pair trade is one of the additional feature, and other studies also additional feature. So this is also one of our software available. So this is the view of the software. This is how the software look like. The analytical methods you are going to learn in the program. I have already shown you how the software look like. This is option strategy software. This is one standard deviation software. This is GAN time analysis software. This is a smart IT all-in-one tool which has pair trade and other features. So here I'm just starting the session. We have the RBI review today. RBI review today, and just post review the IVs of the options are going to fall. So I'm going for the nsindia.com. If you do not have the money also, you can just paper trade this option strategy. You can know that how beneficial this option strategy trade is. So that is, so I'm just going for the NSE site, and I'm just going for the Nifty. So I require some 5 to 10 minute gap. So during that gap, we can discuss this one. So I'm going for the Nifty, and you can just go for the option chain here. So you can get the option chain here. Nifty at 10,953, and these are the options are trading. So just have a look on the IVs. So though it is not the real-time IV, once you calculate in our software, you will get a different IV. But have a look on that. This is for reference purpose. It is very good. So you can just have a look on that. All options having a expiry on 8th of August. All options having Expiry on 8th of August. Call options are having a IVs of 25, 26, average you can say 26 or 27. Put options are having a pretty big IV, so you can say that it is having 30% IV, great IVs. But if you just go 1 week ahead, just go to the 14th August, just the next week, just have a look on these IVs. So the IVs of the put options, which was 30% there, here it is 20% average. IVs of the put option, which call option, which was 25, 27 there, here it is 16.5. There is a great difference. 10% difference is there. So now there is a 10% difference is there. I have gone for a 11,000 call option, 11,050 call options I have taken, just higher strike. Now we are at 10,945. I have taken higher. Next strike will be 11,000. And very near strike will be 10,900. So I am just taking for this. I have chosen the strikes of 10,900 and 11,000 strikes call and put for 8th August. I have chosen 10,850 and 11,050 call options of 14th August. So what I am going to do here, after choosing these strikes, very carefully listen to this. After choosing these strikes, I am going to sell the 8th August and buy the 14th August. Same strikes. Just record this trade. We are going to sell the 8th August 10,900 put and 11,000 call at 59 and 32. Or 59.7 and 32. We are going to buy 11,550 call option and 10,850 put options of 14th August at 53 and 88 or 89. So this is what we are going to do. Have just record this trade. Market has now, Nifty has come down to 10,927. Just record this trade. You are not going to come out of the trade today, irrespective of there is a 100 point up or down movement, whatever happens, you just need to take this trade and wait for the day. Let the review to be get over. Let Nifty go by 100 point down or 150 point down or 100 point up or 150 point up. Just do not disturb the trade. Have initiate this trade as per record. So here, 10,850 put options and 11,050 call options of 14th August expiry. 14th August expiry, you are entering at 86 and 56 and you are 10,900 put options and 11,000 call options of the 8th August expiry, you are selling at 61 point something, or 61, you can say 61 and 32. So this is what you are doing. 86, 56, 61 and 32. So this is what you are doing. So prices will change slightly, 1 or 2 rupees up or down. So this is the trade you have entered, and irrespective of the Nifty movement, do not disturb the trade. Just wait for the today for the review to get over, then you take some actions. Trade, what I have explained, because of a IV difference, huge IV difference, so you want to capitalize on the time value. So for that, so IV more, theta is more. So 8th August options are having a higher theta and the 14th August having the lower theta, so you want to capitalize on that theta front. So for that only I have told you to take that. So this one standard deviation software, what I did, I have just downloaded the Nifty. I just selected intraday, calculate, these are the values has come. It is giving you 66 rupees as the price range, and I am selling it. Current price is just below my sell entry price, 2 or 3 rupees below my sell entry price, 943, 944 now, 947 I could have sold. So I am selling it now. If I sell it now, which strike options I should hedge. So hedging is a good practice. So you may be following different style of trading. Some doesn't hedge also, but I prefer the hedging. So I'm telling my style is hedging style. So you please hedge it. So here, if you are selling the future is being sold. Future is being sold. So sold. So which strike option should be hedged with this? So many are saying that 11,950 call options I can buy to hedge it. So this is also a choice. And you have an RBI review now. Why you want to buy a call option? Why you want to buy a call options? So RBI review is there. Even though if it is fall down, it has to fall down till 10,855. This is the level it is going to fall down. So in the first cycle. So RBI review is there. Post review, you are going to see some great decay in the IV. So if you are selling this future, you have say 10,900 or 10,850 put options of monthly options you go for. Slightly higher premium also you can get it. So you are getting 850 put options at 126 rupees trading. 126 rupees it is trading. You can sell off some option also. So with the selling of the future, once you start selling the future, once you sold the future at this level of 10,944 or 945 level, two choices are there. First choice, you can buy 10,950 call option. Preferably you can buy this, but buying of 8th August, I will not advise, because 8th August is having a very, very high IV and it can give you very wrong result. End of the day, you may not make anything. So even though if you are buying, you can buy it. So you are selling here, you buy a 10,950 call option of 14th August expiry. That you can do it. But since RBI review is there, slightly change your style of trading. If this downtrend continues, it go for 10,850. Sell some 10,850 put options. 850 put options. So this also is a good idea to hedge it. So you have a RBI review. There is no point in taking the IV decay risk. Better to sell options instead of buying a call options, sell a put option. So by this process also you can hedge. But if you do not understand that, then the easiest task will be hedge it with the 10,950 call options. Preferably choose the 14th August expiry, or you can choose for the monthly expiry 29th August. But do not buy 8th August options. It has a great, great IV. So now this is for the Nifty. We have done and we have entered to the sell trade, and it is at some 10 to 12 point profit also now. So you have that levels, and more than this particular trade, the most important thing you need to watch is these levels. So these recordings will be available with you. Just watch these levels where the stock has given support, where it has given a bounce back. So this is very important. Days low basis, days high basis, days closing basis, whether these prices have come or not, that will be a great idea for knowing the performance of this tool. So you have done an analysis, whether this analysis has worked or not. So I'm going for the Bank Nifty. Same way I'm going to load the data. I'm going for a calculate. So now these are the levels are coming in front of me. So 28,174, 28,031, and currently I am at 27,992. So 27,992 or 27,995 level I am at. So 27,992. So here one declaration we have given here. Buy sell entry must be happened at 0.382 level. So your selling should happen here. Your buying should happen here. So Bank Nifty, because it has a higher base value, As per Fibonacci, it says that 0.382 only, ratio only confirms your trend. So not the 0.236. So here you get, if you want to make a buy entry, you must wait for 28,219 to cross over. If you buy here, 28,219 to buy here, which strike option you should sell, which strike option you should hedge? If you are buying, if you are selling at 27,987, if you sell here, which strike option should be hedged? You can go for the 28,000 call options, 28,000 call options here, 28,000 call options to buy. You can go with 28,200 put options to buy, 28,200 put options to buy. But one thing you have to remember, RBI review is there. You cannot make use of 8th August expiry options. It has a very, very high IV, very, very high IV. So you need to focus on 14th August, or you have to go for the monthly options. I'll suggest you go for the 14th August. I'll suggest you that better, instead of buying some options, try to sell some options now. Try to sell some options now, because the IV is going to fall. So even though your future trade will be at profit, but IV fall may drag down your profit back. So for that reason only, it is better that you should sell some options. So I have already explained to you in the Nifty, this is the trade you are going to do. So you can say 14th August you are buying, 8th August you are selling. Can you have a similar kind of strategy in the Bank Nifty? Because why these strategies are initiated? Because of RBI review. So I am just going for 28,000, because you are at 28,000 call options. Great premiums you will be getting, 200 rupees premium. Put options also 243 rupees premium. Great premium for 8th August Bank Nifty. And just go for, here's 200 premium you are getting, so you can go for two call options for 14th August and 28,200 call option. And same way, you can go for 27,000 put options, 27,800 put options of 14th August. Put options of 14th August. So how will be your strategy will be for Bank Nifty? Bank Nifty, 14th August. So Bank Nifty, 14th August, 27,800 put and 28,200 call. Buy it. It will not buy it for 14th August. And for 8th August, 28,000 call and put, both you sell it. Great premiums are there. Very lesser differences are there also. So sell it. It will take very less amount of margin also. Hardly some 1.5 lakhs margin may be required for this. And do not disturb this strategy till the review is not over. Let the review to over. Let the review to get over. Then if you find out that there will be a consolidation between 27,800 to 28,200, between these two values, if there is a consolidation happens post result, then your profit will be great. So these options having just 2 days of time value, just 1 day time value, trading at a great premium, you must sell it and you must take it the 14th August expiry. Even though if you do not have the capital, just take it as a paper trade. So take it as a paper trade, 28,000 call options, 28,000 call options and put options. You are selling at 213 and 228. 200 and put is 228 and call is 213. So this is for the 8th August. You are buying 14th August 14th August, 27,800 put, 28,200 call. So these strikes I am deciding because I am getting 200 rupees as a premium. So that only I am just deciding 243 or 44 and 233. So this is what you are entering. Even though if you do not have the money, please do the paper trade. Similar things we have done for Nifty. Nifty, what I have told you, 10,900 put and 11,000 call of 8th August, you sell at 61 and 32, I have told. So now also you have 61 and 37, it has become. And same time, I have told you, you should buy 10,850 put option and 11,050 call options at 56 and 86. So this is what we have told. So let us wait for the event to get over and take action. So now we have taken for the Nifty. So where the Nifty stop loss lies? So Bank Nifty has come. So here, where the stop loss of the Nifty lies? So whatever the analysis you do in the software, it stores in a cloud. So you can able to retrieve it anytime you want. So today, what are the analysis I have done? Nifty I did. Bank Nifty I did. That analysis is coming here. So can anyone will tell me what will be the stop loss for the Nifty? I sold at 10,944. I hedged it. Here I have sold it some 3 to 4 point below. 10,933 also has come. Where will be my stop loss? As per the Fibonacci, 10,990. So this is the 989 in fact. So 10,989. So here is my stop loss. 10,989. So do not count the points between this. I sold it here some 44, 45 points I am losing in stop loss. So that is why you have hedged. So once whatever the amount stop loss if it hits, if this 45 points of stop loss is coming in the future, out of that some 25 points or 20 points could have been recovered from the option. So trend change has not happened, just go with that particular thing. So now these two strategies, do remember always when there is a RBI review, when there is a every 2 months there is a chance it gives. Every bi-monthly review will be there. So every 2 months you will get a chance to initiate this kind of one strategy. So if you have enough capital, so 2 to 3 strategies also you can take it. So this is also can give you a great comfort of to earn from this strategic trade. In fact, it gives every week it gives that opportunity to trade. So fine. So this is what you have analyzed for the Nifty and Bank Nifty. And Bank Nifty, we did not get any chance to buy or sell now. 987 has not come post to analyze. 28,219 also has not come. Let us wait for that breakout to happen. Then you can sell. If I do the similar analysis in my Smart IT all-in-one tool, how it differs? Suppose if I am going for index future, going for the same Bank Nifty is being displayed there. So how it differs? These two softwares, one standard deviation software, whatever the readings you have got there. So 218, 987, same thing comes here also. But how it differs? So you have volatility, Fibonacci parallel projection, lot of studies. But one very important factor is the summary. So out of this, each time you analyze, you can able to know out of these studies, 5 prime studies, we have not taken this pivot things into that. Like Fibonacci is being included, volatility included, 1SD included, Elliott included. So Fibonacci parallel projections also included. So out of these 5 different studies, how many studies are suggesting buy? How many studies suggesting sell? How many are neutral? So currently no trend breakout has happened. Only one study is giving a sell. Remaining no study is telling to buy. 4 are neutral. But once the things have changed, once the trend breakout happens, that time this scenario also will change. That time So this summary also improvised your success rates. Even though Nifty has given a breakout, that time if you can have a look on this summary, you can get a great idea that whether I should buy here or I should sell here or I should not do any trade now. So that part also you can able to know it here. So now I'm coming to the Gantt's time analysis. So Gantt's time analysis, we are publishing every month, we are publishing the report. Which are the days the trend reversal date, trend reversal is going to happen? Which are the days the trend reversal is going to happen? So we are giving these dates. But currently we have added a very good features in this software. So if you go for the trend analysis, this trend analysis scans the stocks for trend change. This is one button is there. So if you just click on this button, this will scan the stocks which is having the trend reversal date falling 8th of August. Today we are in 7th of August. This also we are going to improvise. So 7th of August, what is there? We are in 7th August. 8th August, which are the stocks are having the trend reversal date? That we are going to, we are scanning here. So here we are getting, this is three. If you are a regular user of this trend reversal software, you will be knowing that there are three interfaces there, three major trend reversal date calculation. One is low angle, high angle, and in high low squaring. So these three methods give you major trend reversal dates, means tomorrow's trend reversal date is going to happen. And second factor we have included, based on closing. So suppose if you say that we have Adani Power, tomorrow the trend reversal date, 8th August, you have a trend reversal date for Adani Power. If Adani Power just closes at 6094, means it is in uptrend, 60 rupees 95 paisa above, very carefully listen to this. If it closes above 60 rupees 94 paisa, then today means on 7th, tomorrow its trend reversal is going to happen. So today 7th August, if Adani Power closes above 60 rupees 94 paisa and below 63 rupees 57 paisa. So if it closes above 60 rupees 94 paisa, it is closing at uptrend. So I am expecting 8th, it should have a downtrend. It should have a negative opening or negative closing. So this is what I am expecting. If Adani Power have a positive opening today, means on 7th of August by 3:30, 8th of August, I will expect this stock to have a negative opening or negative closing. But that 7th August closing price is very important. So we have done some Gantt's calculation, we have given it here. If it is closing above 60 rupees 95 paisa but below 63 rupees 57 paisa, then it is in the uptrend level 1 only it is closing. So the trend reversal, the chances of trend reversal will be 45 to 60%. It may be 50-50, you can say. There is a 50% probability the trend reversal may happen, will happen on 8th, or trend reversal may not happen on the 8th. But if it is closing above 63 rupees 60 paisa, then this same probability, once it is closing in the level 2 level above, if the price is above the uptrend level 2, then chances of this trend reversal increases to 65%. Probability of success increases to 65%. So this scanner is going to help you many ways. So earlier you will be knowing that, okay, trend reversal is going to happen, but some cases it is working, some cases it is not working. So I'm not able to fine tune that which are the stocks are, means which stocks it is working, which stocks it is not working. So we have given some price analysis with this also. If it is closing above the uptrend level 1 or the downtrend level 1, then its trend reversal, chances of trend reversal is just 50%, 45 to 60% you can say. But if it is closing in the level 2 downtrend or level 2 uptrend, then the chances of trend reversal goes to 65% plus. So here also, just you have to take this particular screenshot. Around 315 to 320, how to use it? Around 315 to 320. So you just see these stocks at what price they are trading. 315 to 320 period. Or only 5 minutes is enough nowadays to enter a trend. So 320 to 325 period also you can see. So if you are seeing that, okay, these stocks are in the, you can say ICICI Bank is in the level 2 and Indigo is in the level 1. So you can say ICICI Bank is the best choice now to enter, or it has higher probability to accept the trend reversal date tomorrow. So this scanner is a great way, it is going to help you. Low angle basis, what is there? High angle basis, only one stock comes. High low squaring basis, only 6 stocks come. Infosys comes here, Glenmark comes, Hexaware comes, Arvil comes. So this is the new feature in this software. Other than that, you have whatever this individual stock study was there, that is still present here. Individual study we have not disturbed. So it is there. Individual any stocks, you can just load it. You can get its trend reversal date calculations. Trend reversal date calculations along with its GAN square of 9, square of 12, GAN angle volatility. So all these things you can utilize for your midpoint method. So for your intraday calculations, you can utilize these methods. So GAN angle and volatility, all things you can utilize for the intraday analysis. But the time analysis, when it comes, these are the individual stocks. And we have added this new feature. So this you can update your software. When it prompt for update, you update the software, start utilizing this feature. So we have Nifty bounce back. It has come down to 10,784.83. It has come here. So 10,989 level is my stop loss. So 10,989 level is my stop loss. And these are the that stop loss has not come for me. I'm at this thing and I have also hedged my position. So my positions are hedged and I am at this level. So let us see. If stop loss triggers, what I need to do? I have to close the future. I have to close the options what I have hedged. I have to accept if the stop loss hits, I have to accept 44 point loss in the future. I have to recover near to 20 point from the option hedge, and I will just go with the other trade. So let the price to cross over 10,989 or 90, then we should take some actions. So ICICI is having a trend reversal date tomorrow. Currently, so ICICI future it is. So currently, I have to add the ICICI equity. So all this trend reversal date is being calculated based on the equity stocks. So I have ICICI. How many of you are the intraday option traders? How many of you are the intraday option trader? If you are intraday option trader, please make it yes. If you are not intraday option trader, say no. Or only yes people can say. Intraday option trader. How many of you are trading in options for intraday? Out of your 105 people now, how many of you trade intraday options? Fantastic. Near to 25 to 30 people, or more than that, more than 50 people are trading in intraday options. So mostly the intraday options are the buyers. They used to buy the options. Some very less proportion of the people are the option sellers. So can today is a good day for doing the intraday trade in option? Is it a good day to do the trade in the intraday options today? Those who are the intraday option traders, can anyone will tell me, is it today is a good day to buy the options? More specifically, today is the RBI review day. Many of you have already attended my programs. Many programs you have attended. Today is the RBI review day. when there is such kind of RBI review, election results, Federal Reserve review, or any company's result is coming on that day, on that particular day, what happens? IVs will be very high. So directions may be wild, maybe go up extremely, maybe fall extremely, may consolidate. But IV is any thing, if it is goes up extremely or fall down extremely, in both the cases or consolidated, both on all cases, the IV is going to fall. Post the event is over, IV is going to fall. So IV is going to fall. So on these special days, on these special days, intraday trade in the options not recommended. RBI review dates, election result dates, Federal Reserve review dates, or company result dates. Many companies are giving the result on that date. Buying of either buying of option or selling of options is not recommended. The reason is it may go up extremely post event over, may fall extremely, may consolidate. In all cases, the IV is going to fall. So if you are a seller of option, it goes extremely, you are a loser. If you are a buyer of option, IV falls, then you are a loser. Or if it consolidates also, you are a buyer of an option, you are a loser. So three events, probability of loss is 100%. So when the probability of loss is 100%, better not to trade. Trade is not a habit. Always I used to tell many of you, I have a habit of smoking, means the action of smoking I am repeating every day. I have a habit of snoring, means I snore. When I sleep, I snore. So it's a habit, means the actions which we repeat knowingly or unknowingly, we repeat that actions every day. So trade is not a habit. If you make trade as a habit, then trade is going to ruin you. You accept it today, accept it tomorrow, or accept it after 1 year. If you think trade is a habit, trade is going to ruin you. If you think trade is a business, trade is going to prosper you. Your prosperity will come the moment you think trade is a business. What is a then business? What is a business? Maybe today no customer comes to your shop. Maybe that tomorrow many customers come to your shop. So you are neutral on that. Sometimes you may have to close the shop and go. If you think that there is a risk today, there is a political rally is coming or some disturbance in the market, so my shop will be get damaged. So better not to open the shop. So this is the things is a business. So you don't think that day, okay, today there is no business happen, I got ruined. It is not like that. So sometimes you have to close the shop. So RBI review days and Federal Reserve review dates, company result dates. So those days better do not be an intraday trader, specifically either buying the options or selling the options. Anything you do, the probability of losses is having more. But you can implement option strategies where you can manage your risk. Some managed trades you can take. So I have not told you today when the session started what I have told you, not intraday options I have not uttered. My first discussion I have started, post RBI review IV is going to fall, buy the 14th August expiry options, sell 8th August expiry options, and do not disturb that trade, hold it the trade, let that event to get over, let that event to get over. So then only you can able to, then only you can able to. Anything happens, you have a managed trade. The IV of the 8th August options are going to die down. So nothing can able to hold that things. So it is going to die down. So you have another protection, 14th August. 14th August time values will remain. So you can just take some theta values. And this trade, what I have told you, have a very minimal damage. You can say if it is extreme move happen, Bank Nifty goes up by 100,000 points or 500 points, or fall by 1,000 point, in that case itself you have few thousands, you can say 500 to 1,000 rupees losses you may incur in this trade what I have told you. So however, if it is not moving in that proportion, just a 300-400 movement is there, you are going to get some 20 lot size, means near to some 4,000 to 5,000 rupees profit you are going to get. So that is a good things to make the money in the market. So this is what see, the broker call also is coming now, that you buy it here, it will go in this level. So how it will go, what is the trend behind it? Nothing says that. So ICICI Bank, I was telling you, if by 330, I repeat again, this is my uptrend level 1 level 2, this is, say it is closing at 430, it is positive closing. So can the trend reversal will happen tomorrow? Negative opening or negative closing? Negative open or negative closing will happen tomorrow if it closes 430 today? Trend reversal will happen. If you are for the yes, you put yes. If you are for the low, no, you put no. So no, trend reversal will not happen. Though it is a positive closing, trend reversal will not happen in this. Trend reversal date calculation, perfect, we are coming. But today's closing price, if 330 it closes below 413, it is a positive close, but you may not get the trend reversal happening on tomorrow. Same way, if it is closing at 408, also 408, then also you may not get the trend reversal to happen tomorrow. So this is, price actions also is very, very important. Though many webinars I have explained it, why that's price actions, trend positive closing and trend negative closing. I was telling, simple one rupee above or 1 rupee down closing is not considered as a trend positive closing or a trend negative closing. So you need to calculate the trend positive closing or trend negative closing. If the closing is a trend positive closing or trend negative closing, then only the trend reversal will happen. Or else, what will happen? Previous day, what is the trend positive closing or negative was there? So based on that, you can able to. These are the spot prices, equity prices, not the future prices. These price analysis are from the equity price analysis. So this is the way you can utilize this scanner. So this is the way we can utilize this scanner. Miss it, even though if you miss it, you can also form similar kind of strategies. So now we are in a situation, what happens here currently? Currently, I used to say that it is a high volatile situation. What is a high volatile situation in index? What is a high volatility situation in index? Is greater than 20%. Greater than 20%. In fact, pricing forms fronts, it is just near to that. However, greater than 20% index is a high volatility situation. Any stock is having a greater than 40% of volatility, annual volatility, is a high volatility situation. So in this situation, what happens? Any trends gives you a breakout, any type of trend, whether the uptrend breakout given or a downtrend breakout given in any high volatility situation. So any trend breakout does not give you any conclusive trending market breakout. I repeat, any trend breakout in high volatile market does not give you any trending nature of the market. Trending nature of a market means, so today it has crossed two resistance levels, settled somewhere. Tomorrow it will cross another two resistance and settle there somewhere. So that will be a trend, will be continuation pattern should set in. So that doesn't happen in the high volatility situation. That's why we are more afraid of the high volatility situation. So there, what happens? Any trend confirmation happens, it is not reliable. It may reverse back also. You would have seen now, just few seconds back, one broker message has come, 10,975 you buy the Nifty. Now it has come down to 57. 10,957. His stop loss is got hit. So now he will again send a message that after 50 cross down, again he will pop up a message that you sell it here. That time also it will stop loss will get hit. So this is the day, you can say this scenario is being inherited because of RBI review is one thing. So buying up options is not advisable. Even though you entered to the future trades, it must be hedged. And if you have not hedged also, if you do not do the intraday trade in this day also, it is better, I can say. But one thing to remember, hedging should be there. And second part of the things is high volatility situations, trades are not reliable. So in that time, what we should form? There are two strategies we can form. Only two strategies on those high volatility situations you can form. The first strategy will be long ratio call spread. So short ratio call spread or long ratio call spread is there. Long ratio call spread. So here you buy one in the money option, buy in the money ITM, ITM options, and sell two lots of OTM. OTM. So this is one strategy. Second strategy you can form. Second strategy is wide wing butterfly. Wide wing butterfly means, suppose if you are buying 10,800 call option, imagine in this order, 10,800 call options you are buying, selling one lot. 10,800 call option, you sell one lot. You buy 10,900 call options, two lots. At same time, the difference is 100 rupees here. You maintain a higher difference. Go for some 11,100 call option. You can sell one lot. So wide wing butterfly means the depth which you have given for forming this ratio call spread. You have to sell one OTM options in the higher depth. So these two strategies only is going to be beneficial in this type of things. As you have seen in this option strategy software, a lot of interface is there. I am going for, say, index future. I am going for Bank Nifty. Monthly options is there. So Bank Nifty. And if you want to make it market neutral also, you can do it. Say call option. We are going for 28,000 call option, 519 rupees is this thing. I am just buying one lot. I am going for a call options, say 28,500. So 28,500, slightly above also you can go for. So here 28,700, 28,600. How much I am paying here? Same thing I am going to retrieve from this. I am going to sell two lots. And once you do this thing, this ratio spreads, you need to have an objective of, say, 3 days I want to hold. So I need to calculate here. If it goes for a bigger level, say 28,900 and plus, then I'll be at a loss. And once it have a consolidation, I'll have a profit. So consolidation, I have a profit. I can have a net payoff also. I can have, like, I have a call combination. I can have a put combination also. Say I have a put option here. I can just go for 28,000 put option here, and I can buy this. I can sell some put options off. So same 700, 600 points I am going for, 27,400. So here I am selling two lots. So here I am buying one lot, selling two lots. So go for these calculations also. So this process you can able to form, and this is now showing you the negatives because the IVs are very high. So based on current IV only it is estimating. Once this event is over and this IVs are fallen down, this scenario will change. The same software can give you the profit. So if you have the Android app, we have given the facility to increase IV. So you can increase the IV by 30% and project the profit, and same time decrease the IV by 30% and project the profit. And this is the normal IV profit. So normal IV, increased IV, decreased IV, three scenarios, three different profits you can get it. If you have our Android app, you can simulate that. So you can get that in a bigger way. So corrections has happened. So I'll have a, I can buy it. Great correction happened. But if he's an option strategy trader, his thinking will be different. So you can say the same way the option. So the option strategy trader, how they will think in the option strategy, that I will explain. My job is here that yes, great amount of correction happened. Now the stock will go up if your view is like that. So equity trader will simply buy and forget. If any trader who doesn't have any logics behind that, they will also buy and forget. If it is slightly intraday trader, you can say that, okay, correction has, major correction happened, so I may hesitant buy, that is also correct. But if it is a option strategy trader, he will have a risk assessment in this order. Say it is 390 level. So he may sell a call option. I'll just show you these things. How butterfly strategy, what I was telling you. He can buy 400 call options, two lots. So by this process, what happens? 28 rupees paying and 19 rupees receiving. So just he can sell a call options of 420. So he can sell one lot and have a risk assessment. You paid 28 rupees 20 paisa, 28 rupees 20 paisa, received 18 rupees 90 paisa, 18 rupees 90 paisa or 19 rupees, you can say. So 30 and here 7, 8 are, so 9 rupees 7 and 7 rupees 50 paisa also you are receiving. Only 2 rupees is putting the risk. So in this case, if there is a 2 rupees is the applicable risk, if 5 days also hold is there, you can say this is strategy can give. If further fall is there, some 1000 to 2000 losses is, it is getting arrested. However, if you start moving up, then it can go for a 4000 rupees profit. So this is the butterfly I was talking about. Why doing butterfly? You have the ratio spread, you have a 10 rupees depth, and here you are writing a 20 rupees depth option. So this is also, this strategy also highly beneficial in the volatile market. The stocks which is having a higher volatility, uncertain market, volatility market, you can initiate these strategies. So this is all about your strategies, all about your trend reversal scanners, trend reversal days. You do not have a stop loss. For stop loss, you need to do for a price analysis separately. So now we have specific offers for this Independence Day, which is starting today to 15th August. All our softwares, if you want to procure, that will cost you 10,620. All our courses and softwares, including taxes, it costs you 16,040. So if you are interested in this offer to book any of your, and it is very small numbers we are giving. So I'm just sending you the link. So if any one of you are interested in to take any of our product, you can opt for that. And this coming Saturday and Sunday, we have scheduled an event for Fibonacci studies. Different Fibonacci studies you are going to experience on 10th and 11th. Timings, morning session 9 to 10 English, 11th to 12 Hindi. So if you are interested, you can register for this session. Tomorrow is the last date. So tomorrow 8th is the last date. It is starting from 10th and 11th. And this Independence Day offer, we are giving all our softwares, which costs near to 22,000. We are giving at a 10,620, including tax. If you have a GST number, you can claim that tax. And all our courses and softwares, you are getting at a price of 16,040. So if you are interested in any of this product, you can just go to this link and have a, you can purchase that things here. Explain this Independence Day offer, what we are going to give. If anybody has any queries, you can get it here. So call here, we'll explain it. Any product related queries, you can call it here, we'll explain it. I've taken the recording, I will share with you. I have shared two option strategies for you based on this volatility condition. So let us see what happens. Nifty, you have sold in, but stop loss has not hit. Just few points from the stop loss point, you have reversed back. Have a look where it is going today. Bank Nifty, you have not got any entry today. And I have just advised two option strategies for Nifty and Bank Nifty for the day. So this is based on post RBI review. We are expecting there will be a IV decay. With that respect, I have just given these things. So have a look on that part. And initiate the positions based on thing only. We have just initiated the position. I have told 8th August call and put to sell and bought the 14th August. Have a look on this strategy. So tomorrow you can close this strategy. Tomorrow also the weekly expiry is there.